Hey everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a Mega Bloks Collector Series Call of Duty set review. This is set number 06822 with 726 pieces. It's the Heavy Armor Outpost. In the United States, this is a $60 set. So, let's go ahead and check out the components. Because this has such a big deal in it, I'm going to get right to the big deal, the main thing. The main battle tank. We'll start from there. It's infrequent enough that we get tanks at all in brick-based building system sets. When we do get them, we usually tend to get fairly small and cutesy tanks. This one here is not small, it's not cutesy. For the small part, there's your scale. This thing is essentially full scale. Well, you know, realistic scale to the figures. That in and of itself is kind of blew me away, honestly. But then the look of this thing, lots of texture, lots of detail. They've used this great new type of camo with multiple colors. You've got kind of a greenish color, you've got a beige color or a tan, probably more like a beige, and then specks of dark bluish gray and dark red all mixed together. So you've got marbling and specks. It's pretty cool texture overall, just the look. I mean, the tiles are still completely flat, and the outside feel of the plastic is still good, but it's the same as before, but it's that great look that you get from that special mix. And then so many detail pieces used on this thing. Added on around the side, you've got the cans and vents. Even as you turn the turret, you can see vents from the top, radiator grills, turbine exhaust exits, and they did a good job of replicating the angles, at least within a reasonable level of accuracy. This thing's obviously based on an M1 series American main battle tank. You can see I've got the turret going around, main gun elevates up and down. You've got your secondary gun here, machine gun on top, which can rotate around and also can elevate down and up. Very nice. It's got its ammo box, belt feed over here on the side. You've got your hatch here in the front, and you can actually put a figure inside of there. There isn't really a lot of detail to see inside of there, but with the turret turned to the side, you can fit figure down in there. Full tracks, rubber, nice and soft, running on a bunch of wheels all the way around. It's easy to make these move. Normally for toys that have tracks, it's tough to make them move, but these are soft and thin, so it's actually, you know, it's easy to get that realistic look as you actually move over terrain if you want to use this for actual play and not just display. You've got a smoke grenade launcher unit used over here. Creative use of that piece. Makes a lot of sense, though. Antennae back here. Again, the jerry cans. Lights. A couple of printed pieces used on here. This is really, really, really nice. Check it out with a couple of figures in place. Just showing you even more how the scaling works out. How good it looks with folks. It's just good stuff. Speaking of the figures, here they are. Captain John Price et al. Stand is not included. It's just to help me to rotate these easily so you can see them. Again, wide range of colors and accessories included with these guys. And if you haven't seen by now all the configurability with these figures, you haven't been watching my videos. I'm not going to go through every single point of them, but just suffice to say there is anything that you can see that is a different color can be swapped out, can be rotated, can be customized, can be modified. And they've given you quite a range of different things to work with here in terms of swapping around the barrels and the sights and the magazines and the stocks and the grenades and the ammo pouches and the backpacks. Look at all this stuff. that you can change out, not to mention your side straps and the belt section and the vest, and the heads can be swapped if you want to. And these figures still just have incredible articulation available, with double axis joints in the elbows and shoulders, ball joint in the upper thighs, knee joints that can be rotated. Actually, you know what? I think I put this guy on backwards. The upper legs here are on backwards, so that's my fault. Still looks okay though. And just amazing figures overall. This guy's got kind of the more heavy weaponry set up. He's got the large ammo box magazine with the belt feed. This one has actually the stock on upside down for just a different look, something I hadn't thought of. It's symmetrical, so you can, the little slot in there, so you can put that either this way, which is technically upside down, or you can put it this way, which is so-called right side up. I'll just leave it the way that they had it. I think it gives you a little bit more range of motion for getting this in a little bit tighter to that upper arm. Grenade, knife, ammo pouch. Really, really nice head on this one. This is my favorite figure of this set as they have them designed. Just for a normal human, partially exposed face with the actual flesh color showing through there. This one looks really good. Nice proportions there, I think. They got the head nice and narrowed up compared to some others that they've done in the past. And then the detail around that helmet is fine, and the paint job is good. The main guy, Captain John Price. Okay, don't like that quite as much personally. It's a little bit more toyish with the slightly translucent color of the flesh tone. It's actually more realistic to have a little bit of translucency there, but with no wash over it or anything. It just looks a little bit too clean, and the eyes are a little bit comical. But other than that, the figure is still well done. Still got all the same articulation. I like the boots on this one actually quite a bit. Actually has tread on the bottom a little bit. You can even feel it. And the other thing with this guy, so there you can see how his weapon is configured right on this one, but he particularly has a knife that is painted. So this is the first that I've seen so far, accessory that has multiple paints on from Call of Duty. You've got the main plastic color here for the handle, and then the blade is painted with metallic silver. So that's a very nice touch. So there you go, that's it for the minifigures, but they also give you some extra stuff in the form of a care package. So there is your care package. Let's see what we actually get with this one. This is just all of the extra accessories that were included with this set. Riot shield, all right, nice. It's got a little handle there so your figures can actually hold on to that. Got an e-tool, right, in camo dark green. Got a flashlight here. Got another ammo pouch. This one's in kind of beige. You got a pack that you can put on the side of a leg or a hip or several different places that'll fit. Binoculars, canteen. Here's another ammo, another magazine. That one's in green. Here's another magazine. This one's slightly longer in gunmetal gray. Here's a magazine in a kind of a dark beige color, or maybe kind of a tannish color. Handgun, radio walkie-talkie, and this seems to be, people seem to agree that it is supposed to be a claymore. It's what it looks most like, even though the scale is way off with the side pegs, but it allows figures to actually hold on to it and allows it to fit into holes like that, peg holes like so. And then, you know, you get the care package itself, the actual crate, and you can just store all your stuff in there, so that's pretty convenient. If you want to have a little bit less chance of losing parts, and it does have these slots in here, but it looks like stuff should be able to fit through there, but the smallest thing you have is a magazine, and unless you really squeeze, it's just not going to fit. So that actually is safe. It will hold even all these small parts and all the way up to this big piece. So good choice on the sizing there, and it closes up very securely. So this is not going to come apart easily. Hold your stuff very well. The last thing included here is a little terrain piece, actually a pair of terrain pieces here in the front. Got a little bit of some sandbag action going on top of some rocks, or maybe that's some other sort of man-made structure. And you've got another terrain piece back here. So a couple of terrain pieces. These can be broken into two. They're really great for setting up figures and getting them to actually be posed, because you can take advantage of the great posability of these figures with a studded base and get them on just one single stud, and then you can just have them, you know, running or leaping or doing any sort of thing that you want. You only need to have one thing attached on there any place. But the nicest thing here is that you get this cloth piece with the camo finish on it, a little bit see-through, lets some light through, very realistic. And it's a nice quality feel. The piece, it doesn't feel like it's plasticky, you know, it's actual, it's synthetic, I'm sure, but still cloth. And the edges don't look like they will tear, because it looks like they were actually melted down, or it was cut with a ultrasonic cutter, so it kind of cauterizes the ends, keeps them from fraying. This is nice. I mean, you know, it's small, there's not much to it, but it's good, and you can get your figures down in here. They actually have these clips included, little C-shaped clips, which are good for setting up a rifle and aiming. You know, you can just set your figure up there. I'm not going to go through all the posing motions here, but see, it locks it right into place, makes it really easy to get a figure very quickly. I didn't even pose him there, you see, and I was able to get a good, still a decent looking pose, a little cocky, but you know, getting the using the clip to hold on to the barrel just gives you a very straightforward, easy way to get that in there. You can kind of rotate it around without having to set up your figure all just perfectly. So it's good for playability by itself. And then if you spend a little bit more time actually posing things, then it actually works out to be good for posing and for display as well. One last thing that's good about this whole set, the way it's set up, and one thing that I didn't show you on the tank, is that you can open up this section back here, which has nothing in it, and it doesn't really have room for figures. You can put a couple figures down in there, really squeezing them in, lying down if you want, but it's really not that useful. But what it is useful for is backing it up here and connecting like so. You can just kind of, there you go, just kind of pinch that in, and turns this all into kind of one thing that goes together. And they actually show that on the box art as an option for how to set this up and set up a little kind of small base, like a little makeshift outpost. So good stuff there too. Overall, this is a flippin' awesome set, and that's not even to say anything about its value. 726 pieces, including three minifigs, fully configurable, and you end up creating a large vehicle. You get this nice cloth piece, which is special and such, and it's $60. The price per part, just that by itself, is incredible. Not even considering the fact that some of those parts go into making minifigs, and some of the parts are large, and the fact that so many of them have special texture and color and everything, and you've got printed parts in there, and you've got the big treads and the big wheels. I don't know how they pulled it off. This is incredible. This is an amazing value, and it's just a cool set. Even if it cost more, if it was $70, it would still be a good value. If it was $75, I'd still think that it would be a reasonable value. $80 would be pushing it probably. But you're just seeing right there, it's actually 60. You're seeing how I feel about its value and how good it is. This is a great one. I very strongly recommend it. And I think if you're going to get one Call of Duty set, period, from Mega Bloks, this would be the one. Because, there is the Dome set that's coming up. Should be on the market any day now. But big old tank, come on. How do you say no to a big old tank? Very excited about this one. Thanks so much for sharing in this experience with me, watching the video. Stay tuned for more. Check out other ones that I've done before if you haven't checked out the whole series, and also other stuff that I've reviewed on my channel. And you can easily browse through stuff and see what's coming up in my queue at JANGBRiCKS.com. So stay tuned for more, and I hope to talk to you again soon.